The United Nations Security Force, as I said, has been working well. I think the Americans have done a good job. The government of Haiti has asked the United States to manage the flow at the airport. While there are 800 to 1,000 planes that are trying to land there, you should know that on the day before the earthquake, only 10 or 12 planes landed at the Port-au-Prince airport. Now they land more than 100 every day on a, basically what is a big one-lane airport, one-runway airport. They are managing it well. There are serious unmet food and water needs, and part of it is just the distributional system does not exist. The government of Haiti was devastated by the earthquake. The United Nations suffered its worst loss of life on a single day in the history of the UN. But the airport has become the de facto operations center of this relief effort. And the Haitian government's building out some offices there so everybody can be in one place and work on a daily basis. The immediate needs, to think about it like this. Right in the aftermath of the earthquake, you had all these people walking the streets, not knowing how many of their loved ones were living or dead, with only what they had on their back, with no food, no water, able to get no sleep, no light anywhere at night. So for days and days, the Haitian people were stumbling over bodies living and dead. And I think, I don't mind the international media showing people in unrest at the food distribution centers and all of that because it spurs us all to do better. But I think you need to know, in my opinion, given what they went through, the people of this country behaved magnificently in the aftermath of a most unimaginable tragedy. And so I think that things are better now, but there are serious problems with getting enough food, medicine, and shelter. What do we need? We need safe, sanitary shelter. The camps are being developed, and both are important. Right now, every piece of green space in the larger Port-au-Prince area in the West is occupied by somebody sleeping at night without organized sanitary conditions. There's a move on that. We need more food and water distributed. We are attempting to set up, even today, a better system of monitoring all the hospitals and clinics in the area. There are basically 8 traditional hospitals and a number of field hospitals and clinics and offshore hospital units that have been set up to do daily monitoring on what are the medical needs so that we can either fly it in or distribute what's already there at the airport in a more effective way. We have to then get temporary schools open and get the kids back in the schools, the teachers before they leave to do something else. And the government itself has no revenues to restore basic services. Everything was taken away. I told somebody I spent last weekend on toilets and trucks. And I say that not to make you laugh, but to remind you of what they are up against now. Right now, we need to figure out how to get through the week. I want the people of Haiti not to have to worry about whether they can eat today, whether they can get water today, whether their kids are going to be hungry today. I want them to at least to be able to know from one week to the next that they have a place to sleep, that it's safe, that it's sanitary, that there's some lighted conditions at night, all of that. I can tell you the thing we need most now is instead of 15 distribution centers for that food, we need 100 or 200, and the only practical way to do it is trucks. And we have money. Dennis and I both, we were talking about, former President Bush and I were asked by President Obama to raise some money. We've raised some money in our fund. I raised some money for a UN fund. We'd like to have a good deal, but we can buy these trucks. We need to get them a distribution network down there to get this food and medicine out. People don't have, the cabs are destroyed. They don't have a way to get around. It is simply not enough, even if we had all the food and water we needed every single day, to distribute it at 15 sites. So if there's anybody here who knows where I can get some, not big trucks, not semis, pickup trucks are slightly bigger. I need 100 yesterday. They do. So I will say again, if you want to help, unless you are in contact with a medical facility and you are sending specific medical facilities, or unless you have access to medical teams, right now we need cash more than anything else, because we got enough cooks in the kitchen and not enough coordination and distribution. We've got to get people to a week-to-week basis where they can think about at least that and not having to worry about getting through the day.